Welcome, everyone. I'm Laura Hsu, author of the Lightroom blog and Lightroom workshops on video at laurahsu.com. In this video, I'm going to develop this photo, giving it a little bit of a faux HDR look. I'm going to really add a lot of light into the shadows, increase the edge definition, and really pump up the color to take it over the edge a bit. Next, I'm going to apply the same develop settings to other photos. And if I like how this effect looks on other photos, I'll save it as a preset so that I can apply it to other photos in the future. I'm going to start out here in the basic panel by working with the highlights and shadows. I want to darken the highlights and really brighten the shadows. So I'll slide highlights to the left to darken, and then I'll slide shadows to the right to brighten. I can intensify these effects by working with whites and blacks. I'll slide blacks to the right to continue to brighten the darker tones. Now whites, I'm not sure I want to affect here. I don't think I want to darken down the brightest tones in the photo any more than I currently have. So I'm going to go ahead and leave whites where they are. But you can see that this is an image-specific decision. I'll come down to presence and I'll add 100 of clarity. Clarity adds edge contrast, and you can see if I double click to reset it again and you watch the photo as I increase it, how it really pops out edges in the photo. Finally, here in the basic panel, I'll intensify color with vibrance and saturation. I'll use saturation to boost all colors in the photo. Now I get to a point where the red starts to go over the edge, but I haven't yet intensified the greens and the blues as much as I'd like to. So at that point, I'll stop on saturation and I'll switch to vibrance. Vibrance is discriminatory. Saturation intensified all colors equally. Vibrance will intensify less saturated colors more than more saturated colors. So you'll see that it'll really focus on the greens and blues and maybe the yellows in the photo. So I'll increase that, looking at those colors. Now the yellow in this photo has gone a little bit over the top here. Now I did say I wanted to go over the top, so that might not be a problem. For this particular image, I could come down to HSL and reduce the yellow saturation, but I'm not sure that that's going to be the case in other photos that I apply this effect to. So I'm not going to make that adjustment at this point. Now I've maxed out some of the sliders here in the basic panel, and I want more. I want more shadow brightening. I want more clarity. So I need at this point to turn to the adjustment brush or the graduated filter tool in order to get more. I'm going to choose the graduated filter tool rather than the adjustment brush, and I'll explain later why I'm not using the adjustment brush. I'm going to start out in the graduated filter tool by double clicking on the word effect just to reset all of the sliders. Now I'm not going to turn this into a complete lesson on the graduated filter, but I want to affect the entire photo. So I'm actually going to click in the gray, click and drag to the right. Now I started clicking right here and I moved to the right. So everything to the left is fully affected, meaning the entire photo is affected. Now that I have the filter drawn, I can set my sliders to whatever changes I want to make. So I'm going to go with more positive clarity and more light into the shadows. If I want even more positive clarity and light into the shadows, I could draw a new filter, or if you have Lightroom 5.2 or later, you can actually right-click on your pin and choose Duplicate, and you'll get another graduated filter. And now that this second one is active, I can adjust the sliders to maybe back off a little bit on my second adjustment. We'll call this good. I'll click on the graduated filter tool to put it away, and I'll hit the backslash key above the enter key on US keyboards to show before, and then I'll hit the backslash key again to show after. Next, I want to apply these settings to other photos. Now there are different ways to do this, but I'm going to choose to copy the settings and then paste them onto other photos. So I'll come over to the left-hand panel here and I'll choose copy. And it's asking, well, of all the settings you could have applied to this photo, which ones might you want to copy to other photos? So I'll start out by checking none, and I'm going to think carefully through this. In my case, it would just be most of the tone controls here, clarity, saturation, and vibrance, and then the graduated filter adjustments. I'll click on copy, and then I'll find another photo that I want to try this on, and I'll click on paste. So this one, again, the yellows are a little too saturated. Let's try this tree here. I'll click on paste. Same thing. Otherwise, I really like it. I'll try another one. I could do this all day. So I like the settings, except the yellows in these photos are becoming too saturated. So before I save these settings as a preset, I want to decrease the yellow saturation. It doesn't matter whether I go back to the original photo or I use this photo. So I'll just stick with this one. I'll go down to the HSL panel. I'll click on the word HSL, and then I'll scroll up a little bit here, make sure I'm on the saturation tab, and I'll just bring down the yellow saturation a little bit. Next, I might as well go ahead and copy these existing settings, test them out a couple times on other photos before I create the preset. So I'll go back to copy, and this time I just want to make sure that I include color adjustments, because that will also grab my HSL yellow adjustment. I'll choose copy, and let me go back to this photo, for example. I'll paste. So you can see the yellow saturation decreased just a little bit there. I'll go back to my original photo, paste, and the yellow saturation looks better there as well. So I like my settings now. I'm going to create my preset. Here in the presets panel, I'll click on the plus, and I'll call this faux HDR effect. And just like the copy dialog, this is asking, of all the settings that I could have applied to this photo, which ones do I want to copy to other photos? So I'll make sure I have the tone controls, clarity, color adjustments, graduated filter. Looks like I'm in good shape. I want to point out to you here that when you're creating a preset, you don't have the ability to include adjustment brush work. That's why I chose to use the graduated filter to apply more shadow brightening and clarity. Now with my preset, if I were to come across any old process version or Lightroom 3 photos, I would want Lightroom to update the process version so that it could apply these tone controls. So I would include process version in the preset. I'm going to go ahead and click on create. Here in the presets panel, I've got my faux HDR effect. So at any point in the future when I come across a photo that I want to apply the preset to, I would click on the photo, click on the preset, and then make any image-specific adjustments. Before I end this, let me just throw in a couple extra stray thoughts that occurred to me. Sometimes with this type of effect, I also like to aggressively sharpen the photo. If I come down to the detail panel here, and then scroll up a little bit to sharpening, I can use these controls to add the sharpening. If you watch the photo here as I add a lot of sharpening, you can really see the details pop. Now, that in fact may look great on a low resolution, kind of creative over the top version here, but if I was going to do a large print, I would want to make sure that I zoom into 1:1 and really understand what kind of halos I might be creating. I'm going to go back to 0 sharpening and then to 100. And in fact, with this type of photo, I do like how it really pops out those flowers. I have a 3-part blog post on sharpening that will explain how to use these controls. The last thing I want to mention has to do with the graduated filter. After I recorded this video, I went in to modify my graduated filter settings. So I'll click on the graduated filter. And I don't see the filter and the pin associated with it along the right edge of this photo. Because I drew that filter in the gray, in other words, off of the photo, it's not showing here. So the secret is to collapse this left-hand panel so that I have more gray space. I can find my pin and make any further adjustments. Okay, so I hope you've enjoyed this video. I know I've exposed you to several tools without being able to give you in-depth instruction in them, but if you are looking for in-depth instruction, do check out my Lightroom workshops on video available on my website. Lightroom 5, The Fundamentals and Beyond is 12.5 hours of training on 61 videos and covers everything you need to know to master and really get the most out of library, develop, and map. And then Lightroom 5, Producing Great Output, covers Lightroom's output modules, where you can learn how to make photo books, slideshows, prints, and web galleries. While you're on my website, do check out my blog for for lots of free Lightroom tutorials and tips. I'm Laura Shue.